Introduction. The class develops the basics of electric motor operation, how there are zones of maximum and minimum efficiency in energy electricity consumption, and how the driver has to drive to perform efficient driving of an electric vehicle. Index. Fundamentals of the electric motor. Electric vehicle driving. Fundamentals of the electric motor. The electric motor of a vehicle is mainly made up of the following components. Stator is the fixed part of the motor. It is a hollow cylinder containing a coil that creates a rotating magnetic field created by the passage of electric current, constantly shifting its polarity. Coil hairpins, it is formed by a set of copper wires. Rotor, it is a cylinder that rotates. It is a magnet creating a fixed magnetic field. Its shaft is connected to the gear or reducer used to move the vehicle. The principle of operation is as follows. The physical principles are based on Ampere's law and Faraday's law. Electricity is supplied by the battery to the stator coil in three-phase alternating current, creating a rotating magnetic field by circulating the current of each of the three phases, dragging the fixed magnetic field of the rotor, making the rotor rotate. If there is a static magnetic field inside another rotating magnetic field, the static field will rotate following the rotating field. For this to occur, the polarity of both magnetic fields must be equal. Two magnetic fields with the same polarity repel each other and with different polarity attract each other. The polarity can be North Pole or South Pole. If the magnetic fields of the stator and the rotor were aligned, were different, the motor would stop. So that the rotor continues to rotate in the stator, it is necessary to reverse the polarity of the rotor magnets. And this is achieved by connecting the rotor coils to a rotating collector, allowing to maintain fixed the transverse direction of magnetism while the rotor rotates. In this way, the magnetisms between stator and rotor are never aligned and the rotor continues to rotate. There are two main types of electric motors, synchronous and asynchronous. Synchronous, the rotor rotates at the same speed as the magnetic field of the stator. They are synchronized. The rotation speed is directly proportional to the frequency of the alternating current that feeds it. The advantages of the synchronous motor are the high performance, size, weight, and speed control they provide. Asynchronous. The rotor does not rotate at the same speed as the magnetic field of the stator. They are not synchronized. The advantages of the asynchronous motor are its high efficiency and the ability to generate constant torque. It also has a low cost, high reliability, and absence of vibrations. Among its disadvantages, we can find a low power density, a possible risk of overload, or low starting torque.
Learned about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as
electric motor fundamentals. An electric motor consists of about 30 components. As all the rotating elements are on one shaft, very few vibrations are produced in its operation compared to an internal combustion engine that has about 2,000 components. And the vibrations it produces, it is also much heavier. The efficiency of an electric motor is very high, between 85-95%. Reaching up to 97% using silicon carbide inverters, the internal combustion engine has an efficiency of 30%. The torque of an electric motor is maximum and constant from low revolutions, so there is no need for gears, and electric vehicles are automatic. The electric vehicle has a gear reduction of revolutions from the electric motor to the wheels, and the rotation of the motor is proportional to the rotation of the wheels. The electric motor has the maximum power over a wide range of revolutions and is constant. The internal combustion engine has the maximum power only at certain revolutions. There is no doubt that the electric motor has many more advantages than the internal combustion engine. Electric motor fundamentals. Efficiency in an electric motor is defined as the ratio between the electrical energy supplied by the batteries and the mechanical energy obtained. The efficiency losses are produced by the Joule effect, by which if an electric current circulates in a conductor, part of the kinetic energy of the electrons is transformed into heat, due to the collisions with the atoms of the conductor material through which they circulate, raising the temperature of the same. Efficiency curves of an electric motor. The graphs show the efficiency curves of an electric motor. In the abscissa axis are the revolutions of the motor, and in the ordinate axis is the motor torque. The electric motor has a high efficiency. Whatever the torque and the revolutions at which it is located, it has at all times an efficiency equal to or greater than 85%, reaching 95%. The zone of maximum efficiency is found at partial loads or half loads and half revolutions. As the graphs show, electric motor fundamentals, zones of lower electric motor efficiency. There are two zones where the electric motor is less efficient, and they are zone of low revolutions and high load. Copper losses caused by the release of heat in the resistance of the windings when the current flows through them. Zone of high revolutions and low load, iron losses. They occur in the magnetic circuit and cause heating and vibration in it. They are due to the circulation of a magnetic flux and can be broken down into two phenomena of different causes and origins, eddy currents and the hysteresis cycle. To avoid these zones of minimum efficiency, some manufacturers have developed two-speed gearboxes. These are always automatic and are used in premium vehicles as they increase the price of the vehicle. With a two-speed gearbox, the engine runs at lower revs than if it will use only one speed at high speeds. The graph shows the results of a Porsche Taycan electric two-speed automatic. The advantages are as follows. Allows you to develop 20% more torque from startup to above 60 km per hour. Allows higher speeds to be reached with less strain on the engine. At 95 km per hour, the vehicle makes a gear change to engage second gear. Higher vehicle acceleration is achieved, driving the electric vehicle. The following aspects must be taken into account in an electric vehicle. The electric motor has a high torque. From low and over a wide range of revolutions, electric vehicles only have one gear, and some premium vehicles are experimenting with two gears. Electric vehicles are automatic, so the driver only accelerates and brakes, including in electric vehicles with two gears. And in many cases, the driver does not even brake, because when he lifts his foot off the accelerator, the vehicle applies regenerative braking. The electric motor has a maximum efficiency zone. With partial loads or half loads and half revolutions, efficient driving of an electric vehicle. The driver has only one degree of freedom, which is the position of the accelerator, because the electric vehicle is automatic and normally with only one gear. Also, the speed of the electric motor is proportional to the revolutions of the wheel. Therefore, the driver cannot choose the revolutions at which the electric motor turns for a given speed. As it happens in a vehicle with gears, this is done automatically by the vehicle. To drive the electric vehicle efficiently, it is necessary to accelerate progressively, avoiding accelerations, brake smoothly, take advantage of inertia, use the most efficient driving mode of the vehicle, etc. Efficient driving in an electric vehicle is much simpler than in an internal combustion engine vehicle with gears, because in addition to driving efficiently, it is necessary to choose the gear of the vehicle so that the engine operates in the area of maximum efficiency or minimum consumption.